Dog is Family on Berks Community Television is underwritten by Answers Pet Food.
Hi, thank you for joining us today on the show Dog is Family, where we celebrate the bond between people and their dogs, where we explore all topics in dogdom. And my name is Barb Emmett. I'm your host and producer of this show, and we're going to have a very exciting time this first half hour. We have exciting guests that are well known throughout the world. So please stay with us as I introduce Michelle Dreger. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Barb. Thank you so much for having us today.
You are so welcome. And aside of Michelle, we have Mark Grounard. Hi, Mark.
Hi, how are you?
Very, very good today. And on the floor, folks, we have an amazing golden retriever named Bean. And welcome, Bean. We're so glad you're here with us. You have quite a story to tell. Bean shares a lot of love, a lot of woof. And you're seeing some exciting things on this table today that we're going to be talking about. And I'm going to get started introducing you a little bit more about Michelle, because she might be a little shy to talk about all of the initiatives that she started and her dog, Bean. And Bean is a 10-year-old golden retriever, correct?
He is. He'll be 10 years old in August. Actually, on August 22nd, Bean will turn 10. And actually, August 22nd is also Bean's National Calendar Day.
That's right.
Which is called Never Bean Better Day. It will be in perpetuity. Where Bean encourages his human friends to get out and play with their canine friends. So Bean most certainly is always sharing the love and has done that now nationally through
this
day.
We love sharing the love. Thank you, Michelle. Let me tell you, Michelle and her husband Jim have had golden retrievers for many years.
Long time.
They have three goldens right now. Jim is an AKC judge for the last 30 years.
Yeah, over 30 years he's been judging
the
breed.
That's awesome. So. A lot of experience here, folks. And Michelle has been doing therapy work with her dogs for over 17 years.
Right.
And Bean has been the celebrity. Let's just talk a little bit about the other Goldens at your home and then how Bean started to come out of the pack.
Okay, sure. Well, we do have currently three golden retrievers at home. We have Trooper. Trooper will be 12, actually. Seems a little antsy because it's hot. Trooper will be 12. Trooper will be 14.
14.
I'm sorry. Oh, my goodness. Time flies.
No,
but
I know.
Trooper will be 14 in May, and he's our leader of the pack. He has competed all over the United States and Canada.
Wow.
So he's well known in his own right in field retrieving. And then Bean is, again, will be 10. He's a certified therapy dog. And he holds his canine good citizen title.
Test.
And then there's Carly. Carly will actually be 6 this weekend.
Oh, my goodness.
And she's our youngest of the pack, and she is actually a Trooper granddaughter. So,
oh, yeah.
And Trooper is Bean's uncle, known as Uncle Trooper to his fans on Facebook. And we don't know what Carly will be yet when she grows up, but she's a bit of a fashionista and most certainly loves being sidekick. So,
well, I understand, since Bean is a Berks County celebrity as well as throughout the world, apparently worldwide celebrities know
yes.
Bean. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so actually Bean actually born and raised here in Berks County, most certainly got his start in therapy dog work right here locally. And then he actually has a natural capability of wooing. And I say wooing the masses, but he really does woo. And in our travels, we came across some folks that were looking for a dog that could make different, you know, sounds. Bean was it. And he was cast actually on Animal Planet's show, The Haunted, for that. So that had gone on, a few years ago. And he most certainly enjoyed that and enjoyed most certainly wooing the crowds. At the same time, social media was just beginning to become popular.
Yes.
And I was actually teaching some courses at Alverni. I taught entrepreneurship classes there. And I wanted to learn more about social media, so I thought my students could probably teach me. And of course, I didn't want to put my own social media page up. So so I teamed up with some students from Alvernia, and they actually built the first bean social media page.
Excellent.
And he immediately ended up with about 500 friends, which was very, very fun.
Very good.
Very fun. But then Bean went on actually to do some more things as we continued our journey. And actually, our journey in life took us out to Montana. And so we left Berks County, started to trek across the country. And actually, Bean made stops all across the country. We documented that through his actually Bean for President campaign.
Yes, I do remember
so,
that.
So Channel 69, WFMZ, did give Bean a send-off for his presidential campaign, so to speak, although he was running under the canine party and just having fun and shaking paws and kissing babies, from Pennsylvania to Montana. So it was a lot of fun. And then when we landed in Montana, that's when Bean went on board with a hospital out there to do some serious therapy dog work, and also with some other organizations, behavioral health groups and therapy groups and so on. Bean has made presence in the courthouse to relieve stress for children that may have witnessed things that would not have been comfortable for them. He has also spent time with Alzheimer patients, as well as has done a number of reading programs for children that didn't have anybody to read to. Bean actually would listen. So Bean has shared a lot of love.
Well, that's what I just keep going back to this. It all does start with love, and it's all about love and sharing, and that's what we'll be talking about, how he has learned and been able to give back in so many ways. And he shares kindness, and that is obvious to me. And he knew that I was having quite the morning as well, and he sided right up to me, and he started to give me the bean. He really has been sharing and doing all that. Can he woo for us now?
He can woo for you. So Bean, most certainly you've got a lot of friends, and I know his friends and fans are actually tuning in from all over the country. I know we've got people from Florida to Texas to California tuning in today, and I know, Bean, there's a lot of great smells, but this is the camera. And can you tell your fans, can you turn around so they can see you? And say thank you. A little louder. Thank you. Hello. Or at least a prairie dog for him. And now a big thank you. Thank you. Woo woo. Okay. I know that we are actually inside of a studio,
yeah.
So for him to woo louder, he actually, because he does therapy dog work in a hospital setting, we have what's called our indoor voice, and we have our outdoor voice. So
yes,
Bean might have got a little... thinking that he might have to use the indoor voice today, but he most certainly woos online quite a bit, and people do tune in to hear him.
Well, on our Facebook page on Godfrey's Welcome to Dogdom, Michelle and Bean had put together their morning video about him getting ready because of the rain in Berks County. What was going on there? You can tune in and see that video, but he was wooing really strongly, Michelle.
He was wooing really strongly. So we had a raincoat, a little red raincoat, or should I say a big red raincoat for Bean, because of course the only day of the week that it's going to rain cats and dogs, no pun intended, and wanted to keep them dry. So he put the raincoat on, and he was reporting on it actually on his Never Being Better Facebook page. So you can most certainly follow his tale on Never Being Better on Facebook and also on Instagram.
Awesome, and he's got over 75,000 followers,
yes,
correct?
Yes, he has over 75,000 followers on social media. So he has them not only, coast to coast here, but he also has them in other parts of the world as well. So he has a lot of fans in Greece. He has fans in France and Germany and in England and in Canada. So he's wooed the masses, so to speak.
Yes, he has, and he's staring right at the camera now.
He is.
He wants to be seen, and he wants to share what's going on in his life as he's been able to give love and kindness to disadvantaged folks, children without. Tell us a little bit more about those, again, initiatives a little bit deeper okay. about his heart and his connection to people.
His connection to people is really big. Most certainly, he's always had the biddable temperament that is so needed in a therapy dog. And so Bean is a comfort dog. He is a comfort dog and therapy dog that's different than a service dog. But he provides comfort. He can sense if folks are stressed or mm-hmm. down or whatever. So there's been a lot of tears cried in this fur. He makes rounds at hospitals and long-term care facilities. He's done work in homeless shelters, and so he has just really connected greatly. At the hospital where we worked together in Montana, is a really big program called, and Bean, they're looking at you, a really big program called a teddy bear. Well, he knows what we're going to talk about next.
Yes, he does.
But it's a teddy bear program, and it's where a comfort toy is given to every child that comes through the door. So a gracious donor at the hospital in Whitefish, Montana, came up with that program for us. And Bean would make the toy drops. He would go around and make the toy drops. So he would take them to the children, or he would deliver them to the different units. And most certainly, he became quite popular because he was sharing the love of those comfort toys.
That's awesome, and we'll get into that very shortly. I know there was a Wall Street Journal connection, too, that you and I had a part of. You want to share a little bit about that before this started to come about?
Right. So actually, at the time that Bean was cast for the television show The Haunted, we knew he would need a fancy new collar to wear, and we made a visit to Godfrey's and said we need to do a little shopping for a collar. And while we were in there, Barb and I were talking, and it was around the holiday time.
It was around the holiday.
And she had asked, you know, what Bean was up to and so on, and I had mentioned to her that he had written the holiday note, basically a message from the whelping box, and was reporting on all the humans were doing, as well as what he was up to. And so I think we were still in the store when you got the call.
And I got the call, right?
Yeah, you got the call from the Wall Street Journal.
I got the call from a writer from the Wall Street Journal that wanted some quotes about Christmas cards at the holidays to put an article in the Wall Street Journal about how people share cards when their dogs are greeting each other for the holidays and sending best wishes. So she was asking me, and I was giving her quotes, and then I said, matter of fact, I know someone else who might have some really great input for your article. And she called you, and what happened after that?
So we did send Bean's version of the holiday letter in to her, and most certainly she fell in love with it, and actually did a little clip of it in the story. But what was interesting is that when we were looking for the story, I was like back in the lifestyle section of the Wall Street Journal.
No!
Looking, oh no, no, it was smack front page.
Front page of the
Wall Street Journal. And so at the time, I do public relations, and I was working with a client in another part of the world, actually.
Oh my gosh.
With a story in the New York Times. And I had the reporter from the New York Times actually say to me when she saw my name, can I ask you a strange question? And I said, sure, what is it? And she said, do you know a Bean Dregger? And I said, the bigger question is, how do you know Bean Dregger? And as it turned out, she her friend was the friend who did the story in the Wall Street Journal.
That's what that was.
And she was actually proofreading it. At the same time that she was interviewing me for a client story on something totally unrelated to dogs. But I thought that was pretty funny.
It was really funny how dog connections and relationships and the moment, timing is kind of like everything, as we always say, right?
And the Wall Street Journal still calls on Bean for sources. So, he'll say, hey, he'll get a call, and does Bean know anybody who cooks for their dog?
Yes, we did that one.
We did that one, didn't we?
Yeah, we did that one.
Or does Bean know anybody that does this with their pet or their dog? And then we try to find people for the Wall Street Journal. So he's not only quoted himself, he's quite the source.
He is quite the source. Well, that was just a great story. I remember all of that, and Bean's just continue to grow. Now, let's transition. Mark is sitting aside of you, Mark Grounard, and he is considered the chief creative director of Never Bean Better, this company that then arose from what you were thinking and doing, Michelle. She calls herself the chief leash holder and so forth, but Mark was this creative director for Michelle. They've had a long-term business relationship. Hi, Mark.
Hey.
Tell us, what happened with you two then that we're suddenly looking at all kinds of ways to roll out Never Been Better?
Yeah, we, like you said, we had a working relationship for years, and she started telling me about Bean, and I got to meet him and his big personality, and then it got into this developing this toy to give at hospitals and nursing homes, and she needed help developing. I think we started with the logo first.
And the,
Never Been Better logo.
The character.
Which, is that this logo?
Yeah, what you see here in the front.
Okay, that would be your first.
So we went
okay.
through several different rounds, different styles of cartoons, and we ended up narrowing in on the one you see on the front of the desk here. And even once we got to that stage, we had to refine.
It's a long process to be able to
capture the personality.
It's not like you can just sit down and make this happen in an hour or two.
Well, I know all of us being dog lovers, we tend to project human traits onto our dogs. You know, oh, the dog's smiling, which maybe it is or maybe it isn't. But you know, we all, and within the cartoon, I wanted to give some of the human traits that people love about, you know, their animals. And but you know, you have to, it's a fine line. You want to keep it looking like a dog, and you know, I always think of that classic painting of the dogs playing poker, you know.
Oh yeah. It's in my office actually.
You know, there's dogs, but they're doing a human activity. And in fact, a lot of the okay, so we start with the logo, and then she said, well, we're going to develop a toy to give away, and then that needed packaging. And we dealt with out in California.
Yeah, so the actual company that came up with our prototypes here based on Mark's graphic is called Beverly Hills Teddy Bear, Beverly Hills Plush. So they do a lot of work for a number of very large plush clients and names, so they're very well respected. And then Mark worked with them quite a bit, because just to be able to take then how long it takes to get the character onto paper, then how do you make that three-dimensional into something that actually looks like, you know, the character as well. So a lot of meetings and calls back and forth, and I mean, even just to get the right colors.
Color.
I can see when my eye looks right down, that's Bean's color. Mm-hmm. Really. And
so,
you have to take care of the eyes to look expressive like Bean. And you have two here now. So how did this evolve then?
Right. So actually, so Bean hasn't only done a whole lot of work with his, human, friends. He most certainly has done a lot of spokes dog work, as well as philanthropy work around his less fortunate canine brethren, as we call it. So he was a spokes dog for the Delaware Valley Golden Retriever Rescue on a number of big projects, raising awareness around puppy mill dogs and the rehabilitation of those puppy mill dogs. And then a very special project where the organization rescued 30 golden retrievers and golden retrieve mixes from a very disturbing situation in North Carolina, and they called that the NC30. So project where they had to go in the middle of the night and get these dogs out of a situation that was very tragic. And so Bean helped to raise the funds to bring them home. And so he has done a bunch of that. And so we were thinking that, okay, while he's a bit tired, but hearing his story, I guess.
He's like, I'm bored now. I know my story.
But he most certainly has, reached and touched the hearts of so many that we thought, okay, we need to develop not only a toy that we can give away to children and a buy one, give one process, which we'll talk about a little bit, but how can we also give something to our rescue and shelter friends that are in need of a buddy? So what Bean does is he is a buddy. He is a buddy to those in need for that moment and taking that worry away for that moment. So he has most certainly spread the love and joy to so many around the world.
And it's going to continue. How about, should we go into your next initiative with Never Been Better and
sure.
the Kickstarter? Should
sure.
we show the video now?
We can.
Are you both ready, or is there something mm-hmm. else you'd like to cover?
I think we can. Yeah, so actually what you'll see next is, really it captures the Bean story in a video format. He is going to be launching a Kickstarter. Now, the video that you see is the full story, the Kickstarter that's going to be launching basically this week, probably today or tomorrow, will focus on the dog toy that you see here, so that we can raise the funds to go to manufacturing with the project. But the interesting concept that you'll see is it really tells Bean's story a lot better than I can sit here
okay.
and tell it. And you'll see a lot of Mark's graphic in there. And then another gentleman who does our digital marketing, he is in California. He's a Topahawken grad, and you'll hear from him in a little bit, too. He's the voice of Bean. So I think the video, we can
Why
go to the video.
Why don't we show the video, please? Thank you.
Hi, I'm Bean, and I'm everybody's dog. As a registered therapy dog, I love to spread joy through caring and sharing and share the Bean Woven, real life and virtually, on social media to anybody who needs a friend. Follow my tail at Never Been Better, and that is really my formal dog name. As everybody's dog, I've fetched up a lot of fans by woo-wooing around the world, and even some of the big dogs have noticed me. This mission is bigger than me. It's my goal to share as much Bean love with others as I can, but I need your help. I'm only one dog. My talented humans, the Beansters, are helping me launch my dream of sharing Bean love with sick and disadvantaged children, lonely elderly, as well as my less fortunate canine friends, through the Toys That Teach Giving movement. The Never Been Better products will spread joy to so many through the Buy One, Give One model that can give thousands and thousands of those in need of a Bean buddy. I'm quite the character, you see. The Beansters even had a cartoon character designed in the likeness of me. It's been a moniker of my logo and makes regular appearances on my Facebook. Coloring pages are given by me to the sick children and elderly as a way to help them live in the moment with me and color their worries away. Then, the humans had this aha moment. I was known to make comfort toy drops at the hospital where I made rounds for all of the children who came through the doors. I inspired the Beansters to develop a Never Been Better incorporated stuffed toy bean that everyone can love and also pay it forward with a gift for those who need a buddy. When I'm wearing my therapy dog vest, I help a lot of humans who need a friend to listen to. I help make their worries go away, even if it's just for a moment. With a Never Been Better buddy, I can help many more in need and help take their worries away too. I can only provide half the magic of the Never Been Better buddy. For the rest to happen, I need you. When you buy a Never Been Better buddy, my Beansters will fetch bean buddies to those in need. You get a bean buddy, and you get to help us help someone in need of a buddy. This Kickstarter is producing the start of the line, and your purchased Never Been Better buddy comes with a pedigree certificate and a paw print original stamp paw of approval by me. Help me make Never Been Better, my firm of endearment, the start of the Toys That Teach Giving movement, and help me reach my goal to be everybody's dog. Will you do Bean a favor? Join in my Toys That Teach Giving movement and share the Bean love. Every dollar counts towards bringing joy. If we meet our goals, we can manufacture this amazing toy. Buy one Bean Buddy for your human and help me give a Bean Buddy to those in need. I haven't forgotten my canine roots. You can also help fur kids have a Bean Buddy. I've barked around the country to support my less fortunate canine brethren, so I want to share the love with all the dogs too. Have a fur kid or a few? Buy them a Bean Buddy and we'll give one to those too. I'll share the Bean love with dogs in rescues or shelters and give them the dog toy version to share joy. Thank you for listening to my tale. Will you share the Bean love with all you know? And please invest so we can make our company grow. We can't share this gift without humans like you. The more you invest, the more you get. Buy an original Bean Buddy or make an investment that works for you. There is no investment in Never Been Better that is too small or too large. We have a lot of work to do if I'm going to be everybody's dog. With much gratitude, be the kindness we need to share. Join the Toys That Teach Giving movement today.
Ah, thank you for that. That was a wonderful video. Comments you want to make? And have I think we have a phone caller waiting as well.
Right. Well, actually, that's the entire story. Like I said, we're going to be launching with the
dog
with the dog toy Bean Buddy. And so actually if you, there'll be information on his page as well as the Kickstarter that'll be focusing just on that. So there'll be more news and more excitement to come as we roll that out.
And we have someone waiting. We have Devin Clark.
Right. So Devin is actually our director of digital marketing for Never Being Better. He is in San Diego. Bean does have a bunch of local friends involved with him, and actually Devin is a graduate of Topahakan and a Berks County person who has grown up here and part of our pack. So we're so happy that he could call in, and he's actually our voice of Bean and the producer of our video.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi, Devin, voice of Bean.
That's right.
Awesome. How did all of this come about, Bean? You have your fellow Bean here. How did this come about, this creation and getting Bean's voice? That has another part of the challenge.
Yeah.
Can you well, how it happened is we were busy working on the Kickstarter video. And we were trying to find a voice actor or actress for Bean. And one day, Michelle calls me and says, hey, wait a minute. You could totally be the voice of Bean. You have the voice for it. And at first, I couldn't believe her. I'm like, nah, no way. But then I recorded it, and then I'm like, huh, it makes sense.
It's great. It's great. And you'll be involved in this next campaign step, I guess, huh?
Yes, the Kickstarter is actually under review now. We finished everything, finalized everything up this week. So right now it's being reviewed by Kickstarter themselves to make sure that it's all like the real deal and ready to go.
Excellent. What a coordination of expertise.
We should hear it probably today or by tomorrow for sure, I would think, that we're going live.
Can we hear Bean's voice now say something to us before we move on, Devin?
Sure. Hey, everybody, please support us.
There we go.
Support and see everything that's going on. See how far we can go.
Excellent.
Bean wants to be everybody's dog. So.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's right, Bean. Oh, my goodness, that's awesome. And we might have some Beansters, it sounds like. People following?
Yes, Beansters. So actually, Bean has, I know, some folks following from all over the country today. So
excellent.
So it's great. And I don't know, Bean, do you want to have something to say? Would you like to thank everyone?
Would you like to thank us or thank your viewers?
Would you like to do that? Well, you have to turn around and look.
Talk about all your things.
You want to say?
Oh.
Can you tell? Okay, shake it out. Yeah, you go ready? Ready? Tell them. Ready? Say it. Thank you. Thank you. You're too tired now to talk.
It's warm.
You were talking. Come on. Give him the business. Tell him. Yeah. And what else? And more? Can you tell him? You're not saying it. Yeah. He's pretty hot under the lights, I suppose. Mm-hmm. But
I think he is.
Yeah, but you know, Bean will answer you if you ask him a question. He's supposed to do that. So.
Oh, should I?
So you can most certainly try. Would you talk more for Barb?
Can I ask you, Bean? Hey, Bean.
Hey, Bean.
Bean, did you have a good time today? Did you have a good time today?
Tell her.
Did you?
Tell
did
her.
You have a good time? Did we have fun?
Oh.
Did we have?
Did we move?
You did. Was it fun? Bean. All right. Excellent. Thank you so much for being on our show. We can't wait to keep seeing what all develops on your team.
Thank you.
And how can people find you again?
So most certainly the best way to find Bean is to follow him on Facebook.
Okay.
Never Being Better. At Never Being Better Woo Woo. You will most certainly connect with him there. If anybody else wants to, talk with Bean or whatever, that you can instant message him through there.
Okay.
He also has a website, so that's www.neverbeingbetter.com. And you can follow what's happening with the toy production, the Kickstarter. You'll be able to link to the Kickstarter there. catch his blog and all that he has going on right now. So,
are you running for president? That was my question to ask you.
Okay,
are we making another run?
Well, do you want to tell him? Are you running for president? She's asking you.
Are we making another run, Bean?
Tell her.
Are we doing it? You ran last time.
Tell her.
How was your support? And are you going to run?
Well,
fans,
are you thinking
know.
About it?
Fans want to know, Bean. Are you running? Are you running? Are you running?
I think he's saying no.
I think he said no. Are we not running for president? You don't want to throw your hat in the ring?
No.
Your fur in the ring?
No.
All righty.
All right, Bean.
Very good. We'll let it up to the others then. Thanks again.
Thank
Mark,
you
any
so
other,
much.
Any other comments being this creative director for this? Would you enjoy
just
this?
That on the website, I guess they'll see every holiday we put out an illustration and a coloring page.
That's right.
Yeah, so there's an illustration
so
and
you can download
page.
Or print from there.
All the different holidays, and so they're on his website as well as we put them up on the social media. And it's been really fascinating how people do print them. They share them in different long-term care facilities.
Excellent.
Memory care units.
Excellent.
As well as in schools and so on. So most certainly, Bean says, color the stress away.
Yeah.
He's most certainly, he's all about living in the moment and just... sharing that love, and that's what he does mm-hmm. best.
Yeah, remind and, people. Mm-hmm.
And the comments just behind the scenes are amazing. Everything from my child has a brain tumor, and Bean is posts on his Facebook page, help her get her through her rough days, you know, to I have dialysis, to and it helps me through my long treatment sessions, to just watch him and hear him woo. All the way up to the 90-some-year-old, you know, folks in nursing homes who actually, the folks put their, his little videos and stuff up for mm-hmm. them.
Awesome.
On the actual screen, and it and they stay in tune. When Bean works with Alzheimer patients, it's really very amazing to watch because a lot of times they're in a quiet phase for a long time, and then when they know that Bean or any therapy dog, Bean's part of the Berks County Therapy dog group that goes around, and they come out of that quiet phase, mm-hmm. and it's really very amazing.
Very
and,
powerful.
Very mm-hmm. powerful. And Bean will be releasing stress to college students. Actually, uh-huh. coming up, he'll be making rounds to the different campuses here in this area and some other areas. And I believe it might be next Tuesday he'll be at Penn State Berks.
So. Okay. Follow Bean. You're a dear, honey. And we
so
thank you so much. Stay healthy. Stay happy.
And Barb,
thank you. Sharing the woo. You're welcome. Thank you all three for coming out today.
Mm-hmm.
There you go, folks. A story of how your life can change, how you can be led in different directions. Michelle probably didn't think she was going this way, what, 6, 7 years ago?
Yeah,
years?
About that. So I just humbly hold the leash.
She humbly holds the leash.
And I'm enjoying the ride.
Oh, that's perfect. Thank you, Michelle. And thank you, Mark, again.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
You're welcome. And Devin out there in San Diego, he's probably hung up by now, but we were so appreciative of him calling in to hear his voice. And enjoy. We're going to take a brief break. We'll be back with some quick topics for you as you're looking at your dog food. Bye-bye. We'll be back.
Thank you.
Dog is Family on Berks Community Television is underwritten by Answers Pet Food. Thank you.
Hi, thanks for staying with us for this next brief segment. I think there's some tips that are going to be very helpful for you as people struggle with selecting the right dog foods for themselves, and particularly in dry dog food. What I want to talk with you about are carbohydrates. Why are carbohydrates important to know in your dog food as far as how much is in them? Has to do with low glycemic index and removing some of the sugar conversion then from carbohydrates in your dog's body so that we can look at eliminating some chronic conditions. And it's important for you as you're looking to select the foods that you want to feed your dog. And it's not a hard calculation. We're not going to be doing a lot of high math. Let's look at this. What is very interesting as you start to dig into label reading and so forth and what's going on in the pet industry is that right now the FDA requires only 4 nutrients on the label of a dog food bag: proteins, fats, fiber, and moisture. You can go to your bag and you can turn that around and you'll see that. You're probably sitting there thinking, though, they're only talking about proteins and fats. So if all foods that we eat, human and animal, food is comprised of proteins, fats, carbohydrates, and moisture. All foods. Why aren't the carbohydrates listed on the back of the bag? They make it more difficult for you. All of us that really do study pet nutrition and ways to feed are really encouraging and pushing for the carbohydrate levels to be listed on the back of the bag. But why isn't that major macronutrient, a carbohydrate, reported? It's missing. So it's not really hard. It's not difficult math. Let's look at the next slide. Carbohydrates then can be simply calculated by taking away what is reported in the bag. So if you take 100, which is 100% of anything, that food in that bowl, and you minus your protein percent, the fat percent on the back of the bag, the moisture percent, and ash. Now, some dry dog foods will not report ash. What you can do is use an average of 8% for ash. So simply, let's say, in my example, on the back of a bag, the protein is 26% reported, the fat is 14, the moisture is 10, and the ash is 7. Then, therefore, to figure out how much carbohydrate is in that bag of dog food, you're going to take your 100 minus the protein, the fat, the moisture, and ash, 7 to 8%. That bag reported 7. So your amount of carbohydrates in that bag of food is 43%. That's relatively high. What you're going to find as you start looking to figure out how much carbohydrate is in your dog food, you're going to see the differences. And what will rock your boat, I think, a little bit is thinking if it's grain-free, it's low carb. And that is definitely something that is misunderstood, and that is not true. So as you're looking, they're filling that bag with different levels, different types of carbohydrates that may not be grain. So I need you to start looking at these numbers as you're thinking about, my dog's older, my dog has cancer, or my dog needs to reduce the glycemic amount in the food. carbohydrates are your friend. You need to understand to get them out. They're not the best friend for you. So here's a simple calculation to follow. Please, you know, keep it with you and think about it, because we're hoping, again, that this number will start to be reported on bags of food. There's a wide difference, and some brands are known to have higher levels. It's going to probably surprise you. So that was our first one, and a quick tip on label reading. The next one I want to talk about, this one's really interesting. And the pet food blogger Rodney Habib had worked with some of the professors that were studying this, and is reporting it, and it's pretty interesting. Here's another one. As you know, you all know this, on the ingredient panel in dog food, when you turn that bag over, you're going to read the ingredients left to right and from top to bottom. The first ingredients are always what is most in the bag. So you can bet your bottom that what started first is the most concentration in that bag. Greatest to least ingredients. Well, one of the regulating bodies in pet food is the Association of American Feed Control Officials, AFCO. And when it comes to fat, they recommend that dry dog food contains at least 0.3% sodium at a minimum for both maintenance and to support normal growth and development. Okay, so we know that it should be 0.3% minimum, not too much higher though, but not really listed. So that's been a recommendation. Now, when we start to talk about the salt divider in dry dog foods, this is coming from professors that have researched some of this and had written some books about the topic. Their quote was, because most pet foods use similar formulas, our rule of thumb is that any ingredient that follows salt on the ingredient list must make up less than 1% of the diet in that bag, the food. And this has to be true. It has to be less than 1% for ingredients like vitamins and trace minerals, because only tiny amounts are needed in a dog food. So that's where you're normally going to see anything below salt being synthetic vitamins or minerals, or in one or two cases of dog food, the true vitamin or mineral. But that doesn't happen very often. It's almost always synthetics. So salt can be a convenient marker of quantity of what's in the bag. This is called the salt divider. So if you start walking around talking about the salt divider in your food, people are going to listen. They're going to think, what's this about? Let's look at a label. This last one is showing you a sample dry dog food label. You know what? It starts out really well. Organic chicken, potato, Arctic char, a fish, chicken fat naturally preserved with tocopherols, natural preservatives, sweet potatoes, dried egg product, peas, natural chicken flavor. So they're listing the type of flavor. They're listing the type of fat. That's good. We want to see specifics. Pomace, flaxseed, lecithin, potassium chloride, and then we see salt. It's highlighted there. Let's keep reading the label. So we know that probably 1% of that whole bag would be salt. So what's below that is less than 1%. Okay, we're going to keep reading. You're going to see some of the vitamins, minerals. Even duck is down there below that. So you better believe the amount of duck in that bag isn't significant. Then you're reading apples, organic cranberries, yucca shindiglera extract, crab and shrimp meal, and mussels, and so forth. Organic dried blueberries, organic dried pineapple, honey, organic dried rosemary, and organic dried parsley. Folks, this means that there's less than a pinch of those ingredients in green listed in a 40-pound bag. What's going on then? You know, you're going to look at that 40-pound bag, and if you're buying that bag thinking it says cranberries and you see it below salt or a derivative of salt that they may put in there, instead of using the word salt, you might only have 3 or 4 cranberries. You cannot use that bag of food to work with your dog's urinary tract issues. We know cranberry extract can be very good for keeping the health of the urinary tract. You cannot rely on things below the salt divider to be high in antioxidants if it says blueberries. It's not enough. You need fresh blueberries. You need fresh apple. You would need the fresh cranberry or the cranberry pure extract powder. So these are two tips then to think about: the carbohydrate levels and the salt divider, and to pay attention to that. It's not deceptive, but it can be when you flip that bag and you look at the picture of the marketing and you're seeing cranberries, vegetables, and things like that that are not above the salt divider, they are below. Is it deceptive? I want you to know that you need to be paying attention to that, because it's a lot of marketing going on. So those are two quick tips for you for nutrition. There are so many things we could be talking about in looking at the bag on the back. I brought one along here. And again, it's another example where the salt is midway through the bag. And below the bag are things like blueberries, rosemary, taurine, all kinds of other pieces of things that you would think, oh, isn't that great? So just start taking a look at salt divider, okay? Thank you so much for watching today. We're going to wrap up a little bit early. Again, my name is Barb Emmett with Dog is Family. We'll be back next month. If you do have a topic you'd like us to cover, please let us know by emailing dogisfamily@godfreysdogdom.com. And I hope you enjoyed the show today. It was a lot of fun for me. And keep reading those labels, folks. Keep doing the best you can. There are many ways to feed. Keep doing what you can do to keep your dog living with you as long as you can. Take care and hug your pups. Thank you.
Dog is Family on Berks Community Television is underwritten by Answers Pet Food.